FBL Jamaic. Information for transformation.
Power must change us in our lives, no matter what that may say. Power must change us in our lives, no matter what that may say. Loud and clear.
We buy low, Rada.
Every power.
Bogba, Bada.
Assigned to demote me.
Si wanya, lati re, misile.
Can you say this with only anger?
People that for me, do you know me?
Do you understand this prayer?
She adura ye ye.
A power was assigned to demote Samson. And the power succeeded. A power was assigned to demote Saul. And the power succeeded. A power was assigned to demote Judas. And the power succeeded. Every power! Assigned to demote me! Your time is up. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name we pray. Silence, beloved. Thank you, Jesus. Wonderful God, we thank you for a morning like this. I will praise your holy name for bringing us to another Power Must Change Hands session. We thank you for the wonderful, wonderful things you have been doing in this program. And we thank you for the wonderful things that have been done here today. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Today,
Loni,
you have released words of prophecies upon this meeting. Lord,
Oluwa,
the meeting is now in your hand. We hand it over completely to you. That which you have promised to do. In every life gathered here today, Lord, begin to perform it. In the name of Jesus, all those whose legs have been swallowed by the powers of darkness, and the arrow of paralysis has been fired into their lives, one by one, let the arrows begin to go back to the senders. In the name of Jesus, lay your hands upon your people. To you, Father, be the glory. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Shout it loud,
hallelujah.
Let's sit in the presence of the Lord. God bless you.
Lord, you know.
Now we are here on a specific assignment this morning. This morning. And then,
you know,
a particular homework will be given to everyone who has come to this service. And that homework shall be done midnight. 12 midnight. So that means you have to try and remain awake till that time. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Okay, hallelujah.
I will explain the homework before we go. But for a few minutes, I want you to pay very careful attention to what you want to deal with here in this program. So let's look for a few minutes at what I call the mystery of ancestral powers. The mystery of ancestral powers. And I want to read some scriptures. The first one is the book of Ezekiel. Ezekiel chapter 16. Verse 4 and 6. The mystery of ancestral powers. Ezekiel chapter 16. Verse 4. This is a topic where you cannot fall asleep. You should not fall asleep.
Akori yoja akori te yo godo sula anire.
I must be wide awake and be alert.
Ezekiel chapter 16.
Ezekiel verse 4. And as for thy nativity, in the day thou was born, thy navel was not cut. That is, he was not really disengaged from the parent. Neither was thou washed in water to supple thee. Thou was not certain at all, nor swaddled at all. Verse 6. And when I passed by thee, and saw thee polluted in thy own blood, I said unto thee, when thou was in thy blood, live. Yea, I said unto thee, when thou was in thy blood, live. The power of the ancestral powers.
Agbara, you know,
in the book of Jeremiah,
anyway, Jeremiah,
we read a CV, a summary of the life of somebody.
Aoka akekuru nipa aye nikan.
Jeremiah chapter 48.
Jeremiah orikeji dini adota.
Verse 11.
Ese kokunla.
A summary.
Akuto.
Resume or CV of somebody.
Nipa aye nikan.
Jeremiah 48:11.
Jeremiah orikeji dini adota ese kokunla.
Let's see what the Bible says. Jeremiah 48:11.
Jeremiah orikeji dini adota ese kokunla.
It says this.
Owipe.
Moab has been at ease from his youth.
Moab uti wa ni rora lati gbewere wa.
And he has settled on his knees.
Ozi ti sile lori gede gede.
And have not been emptied from vessel to
vessel.
Never have he gone into captivity. Therefore, His thirst remained in him.
Ìtọ́wò rẹ̀ wà nínú rẹ̀.
And his scent is not changed. That is, the life of Moab had made no progress.
It
was just as it was. No improvement. No moving forward. No progress. But then, when you look at it deeply,
see,
but why is Moab like this? What is the origin of the problem of Moab? Go to the book of beginnings. The book of Genesis chapter 19.
Genesis 19.
Genesis
19.
Verse 30. A terrible proclamation about Moab. Let's see where it took its origin from. Genesis chapter 19.
Genesis 19.
Verse 30.
Ese ogbon.
And Lot went up out of Zoar.
Lot is jade kuro ni Zoari.
And dwelt in his mountain and his two daughters with him.
O si npe ori oke ati awon omobirin re mejeji pelu re.
For he feared to dwell in Zoar.
Nitori ti o beru ati pe Zoari.
And he dwelt in a cave, he and his two daughters.
O si npe inu wo ohun ati awon omobirin re mejeji.
And the firstborn son of the younger.
Eyi akobi si wu fun atele re pe
our father is old.
Baba wa gbo.
And there is not a man in the earth to come in unto us after the manner of all the earth.
Ko si si okunrin kan ni aye mo ti yo wole to wa wa gege bi ise gbogbo aye.
Come.
Wow.
Let us make our father drink wine.
Yeke abu baba wa poti wine.
And we lie with him.
Awa o si soti.
That we may preserve seed of our father.
Ke ale ni iru omo lati odo baba.
And they made their fathers drink wine that night.
Won si mu baba won mu oti wine le oru na.
And the firstborn went in and lay with her father.
Iye akobi wole to o si soti baba re.
He perceived not when she lay down nor when she arose.
O ko si mo igba ti o duwule ati igba ti o dide.
And it came to pass on the morrow.
O si se ni ijo keji.
That the firstborn son of the younger, behold, I lay yesterday with my father. Let us make him drink wine this night also. Go down in. Lie with him. That we may preserve the seed of our father.
They
made their fathers drink wine that night also.
The
younger arose and lay with him. And he perceived not when she lay down, nor when she arose. Thus were both the daughters of Lot with child by their father. And the firstborn bear a son and called his name Moab. The same is the father of the Moabites unto this day. The problem of Moab,
Ishoro Moab
was that of his ancestral
power.
Question number one in the service said this morning in this message. What are ancestral powers? They are the evil powers in charge of a family from one generation to the other. Powers that are in charge of a family from one generation to another. That's why I say, listen very carefully this morning. What are ancestral powers? There are powers that are assigned to a family lineage. To steal, to kill, and to destroy. 99% of all of the stubborn problems we bring to the house of God. Can unfortunately be traced to these powers. And if you are a black person, it's even worse. What are ancestral powers? They are evil powers assigned to monitor a family lineage. No matter where you roam, no matter where you go all over the world, if you have these powers after you, they monitor you.
If you go
what are ancestral powers? They are powers assigned to afflict a family. And there are so many families under affliction, beloved, I tell you. What are ancestral powers? They are the strong men assigned against a family line. What are ancestral powers? They are the spirits behind collective family captivity. What are ancestral powers? There are powers assigned to execute punishment. Uncaused families. And this is a family is under a curse. The power assigned to see that everybody suffers from that curse. They are the ancestral powers. There are many families. All the men must marry witches. There are many families. The men don't get on. There are many families. All kinds of terrible things go through. The powers that is fulfilling this objective, that
the
ancestral powers. Moab has been at ease from his youth. He has not gone into captivity, and so he remained as he was. He had settled down like leaves, so he's not moving forward simply because his ancestral powers, rooted in incest, was pursuing his life. Thousands and thousands of years later, Moab was still in trouble. What are ancestral powers? They are powers assigned to discipline those violating a collective covenant. When a family has been put under an evil covenant, if somebody breaks it, the power that will institute the discipline is their ancestral power. For example, I know a family in this Nigeria, they are not supposed to eat okra. If you mistakenly put it in the food of any of them and they swallow it, well, anything can happen. The person will somersault from the dining table and what's happening? The powers that do that is the ancestral power. What are ancestral powers? They are the powers constituting the principalities in your heaven. What are ancestral powers? They are the powers sponsoring repeated evil history in a family.
They
are the ones who ensure all kinds of things just go around the family line. What are ancestral powers? They are the powers claiming to be the spirits of the dead in the family. They claim to be the spirits of dead members of the family. What are ancestral powers? These are powers, dark powers you were born with. evil powers on genealogical assignment.
Àwọn agbára búburú tí wọ́n ní iṣẹ́ nínú ẹbí kan.
Inherited or hereditary or heritable powers.
Àwọn agbára tí ènìyàn jogún àbí tí ènìyàn bá lélé.
What ancestral powers?
Kí làwọn agbára ìrandíran?
They are tribal resident powers.
Wọ́n jẹ́ àwọn agbára tó ń bẹ pẹ̀lú ẹ̀yà kan.
They are resident there, they don't leave.
Wọ́n ń bẹ níbẹ̀, wọn kì í kúrò.
What are ancestral powers?
Kí ni àwọn agbára ìrandíran?
They are family tree demons.
Wọ́n jẹ́ àwọn ẹ̀mí òkùnkùn igi ìdílé.
The bloodline demons.
Àwọn ẹ̀mí òkùnkùn inú ẹbí.
What are ancestral powers?
Kí ni àwọn agbára ìrandíran?
They are the transmissible evil powers that people are born with.
Wọ́n jẹ́ àwọn agbára búburú tó ń ranni tí wọ́n bí ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ènìyàn pẹ̀lú.
The bottom line is this.
Ọ̀kúnkúndùn inú rẹ̀ ni pé.
These ancestral powers.
Àwọn agbára ìrandíran yìí.
They possess a dribbling power.
Wọ́n ní agbára àti kénilégé.
A confusing power.
Wọ́n ní agbára àti dánilọ́kànrú.
They even mesmerize the best of prophets.
Wọ́n á tiẹ̀ máa ṣe ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ wòlíì ní rúdurùdu.
The prophet will get confused.
Wòlíì ọ̀hún ìdàrúdàpọ̀ Adébá.
They turn winners to losers.
Wọ́n á sọ ẹni tó ń borí, wọ́n á sọ di ẹni tó ń pàdánù.
This is why this morning.
Ìdí nìyẹn lóòrọ̀ yìí.
This is what we want to deal with.
Ṣàbíbẹ́ dojúkọ.
Moses was the meekest man on the surface of the earth.
Mose o je eni ti iwa re tutu julo loke erupe.
Was a man who spoke to God face to face.
O je eni to nba Olorun soro loju ko oju.
But there was an ancestral power of anger in his family line.
Ṣugbọn agbara ibinu ko nbe ninu irandiran re.
These powers waited for Moses.
Agbara ohun wa duro de Mose.
Until he was close to the promised land.
Igba to ti sumo ile ileri.
Then the power struck.
Agbára òun wá bàjá.
And Moses could not enter.
Moses
the promised land.
Wọ ilẹ̀ ìlérí.
I pray that everyone here today.
Mo gbàdúrà pé gbogbo ẹni tó ń bẹ níbí lónìí.
Under the bondage of ancestral powers.
Tó ń bẹ lábẹ́ ìgbèkùn agbára ìrandíran.
Shall be set free in the name of Jesus. Jésù
òṣèlérà ní orúkọ Jésù.
If I were in your shoes, my amen would be louder than that. Bàjẹ́
òṣèlérà ni àbí ìdílé ìrìnlẹ̀ tí bá yẹ lọ.
Even it will be more aggressive than that.
Wọ́n ní ipa jù báyìí lọ.
Characteristic of ancestral powers.
Àmì ìdánimọ̀ àwọn agbára ìrandíran.
Number one.
Àkọ́kọ́.
They have magnetic power.
Wọ́n ní agbára òǹfà.
They magnetize.
Wọ́n máa fa nǹkan mọ́ra.
Number two.
Èkejì.
They can appear in the dream as dead relatives.
Wọ́n lè para wọn lójú àlá ẹni gẹ́gẹ́ bí àwọn mọ̀lẹ́bí tó ti kú.
So in case you are here this morning.
Bóyá wá wà bí lóòrọ̀ yìí.
You have been dreaming of dead relatives. Dead relatives.
Òbí ńlá òórí àwọn mọ̀lẹ́bí rẹ tó ti kú.
You have ancestral powers contesting for your life.
Àwọn agbára ìrandíran ló ń bá ayé rẹ fínra.
Number three.
Ìgádá.
They have a highly organized government.
Wọ́n ní ìjọba tó ní ètò tó dájú.
With up-to-date evil record based on every family.
Wọ́n sì ní àkọsílẹ̀ tó péye lórí gbogbo ìdílé.
No matter how fast the person is running.
Bó ti wù kó nítorí òun máa sáré tó.
If it is the agenda of the ancestral power to return the person to point zero, it will happen unless you know what to do.
Bó bá jẹ́ ètò àwọn agbára ìrandíran ni láti dá onítọ̀hún padà sí ẹsẹ̀ àárọ̀ àbí bó bá mọ ohun tó yẹ yóò ṣẹlẹ̀ o.
Four.
Ìkẹrin.
They give or they supply information.
Wọ́n á máa fi ìròyìn fún àwọn nǹkan.
Because the picture and every information about every family is with them.
Nítorí àwòrán ni o àti gbogbo ìròyìn nípa ìdílé olúkúlùkù ó ń bẹ lọ́wọ́ wọn.
Five.
Ìkarùn-ún.
They appear as masquerades in the dream.
Wọ́n á máa para wọn bí egungun lójú àlá.
Their ancestral powers.
Agbára ìrandíran ni wọ́n.
They are there to steal.
Wọ́n wà mẹ́ láti jalè.
To kill.
Láti pani.
And to destroy.
Àti láti pa nǹkan run.
Six.
Ìkẹfà.
They are the powers who bring people back to their village or family compound in the dream.
Àwọn ni agbára tó máa ń dá ènìyàn padà sí abúlé tàbí agbolé wọn lójú àlá.
Seven.
Ìkeje.
These powers ensure that a particular family is identified with a certain evil.
Àwọn agbára òun yóò rí dájú pé wọ́n dá ìdílé kan mọ̀ ní pàtó pẹ̀lú irú àjálù àbí ohun búburú kan.
They ensure that a particular sickness in the family is identified in every generation. They convince people that their prayers are not effective. And once they begin to convince the person that the prayers are not being answered, the person is forced to go back to them for help, and that is the beginning of destruction.
Ten.
Ancestral powers, they hate progress and success.
Eleven.
They hate freedom or liberty. They don't like setting people free. That's why prayer to deal with ancestral powers, they are not gentlemen prayers. In fact, to be quite honest with you, if it's only one prayer point we can pray today and pray it effectively, it is worth more than praying 200 prayers and then you are not getting anywhere. 12. Ancestral powers, they hate the worship of the true God. As far as somebody is worshiping the true God, they keep harassing your life. 13. Ancestral powers hinder spiritual growth. Are you here today and you have been born again for 2 years? 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, and receiving the baptism of the Holy Spirit is very difficult for you. It is because of ancestral powers. They are telling the Holy Spirit that, look, this one is our property, don't touch this one. 14. Ancestral powers have no mercy. And they do not forgive. Once you break their regulation, they deal with the person. 15. Ancestral powers continue in operation as long as they are not stopped.
Àwọn agbára ìrandíran wọn máa tẹ̀síwájú pẹ̀lú iṣẹ́ wọn àfitẹ́nìyàn bá dá wọn dúró.
They don't stop you from carrying a big Bible.
Ò ní dí ọlọ́wọ́ kó o má gbé Bíbélì ẹ̀rì mọ̀ káwọ́.
They don't even stop you from saying you are practicing holiness. They won't stop you.
Wọn ò tilẹ̀ ní dí ọlọ́wọ́ kó o sọ pé wọ́n ń gbé ìgbé ayé wà mímọ́.
They won't stop you from saying that you are sanctified, you are spirit filled.
Wọn ò ní sọ pé kó o má ní ìwọ ti gba ìwẹ̀nù mọ́ sì fún ẹ̀mí mímọ́.
You can go to heaven, no problem. But they will ensure that life here is terrible and uncomfortable. 16. Ancestral powers operate an automatic failure mechanism. They tell a person, this is how far you can go. You cannot go further. You can't go beyond this one. And once the person tries to go beyond it, trouble starts. I pray once again. And as many people as are here this morning, and they are under the yoke of these powers, you shall be set free in the name of Jesus. You shall be set free. 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 In the name of Jesus. Thank
you. 17.
Ancestral powers, they make people unable to finish any good project. They you make the person unable to finish any good project.
18.
They ensure that the person does not achieve his or her goal in life. Because that's their agenda.
19.
The ascensor powers, they are the ones that produce dropouts. God did not create any dropout or any failure. 20.
Ogun.
Ancestral powers are in charge of mysterious hardships. That cannot be explained. 21. Ancestral powers. They lock a person up in the valley of frustration. And they sponsor the operation of the spirit of drudgery and slavery. They have no respect for anybody. Let me stop there. When someone is contesting with these powers, you just have this feeling that something is resisting you. But that thing, you don't understand it. And it's not clear to you. It will be like an evil shadow that follows the person around. It has dealt with people in the Bible.
It's
still dealing with people now. Unless we move in to arrest them, they continue their evil agenda. The mystery of ancestral powers is that it can even dribble the righteous. Can dribble the righteous. It could be anything, anybody.
It
would dribble the righteous. It was the Bible that says many are the afflictions of the righteous. But the Lord delivered him from them all. He keepeth all his bones so that none is broken. It's the same Bible that says, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the same righteous do? The ancestral power tribute even the righteous. It dealt with Abraham. Dealt with Moses. Dealt with David. We just read the classic example of Moab. When you are contesting with this kind of powers, we don't need too many words. The only thing that can deal with them is spiritual warfare, which is what we're going to wage here this morning with some very strange prayers. The prayer some of us may not understand, but pray them anyway. How do you break the yoke of ancestral powers? The first is to surrender your life to Jesus. That one is not negotiable. If you are not born again, you cannot invite the powers of heaven to break your yoke. Number 2, you need to repent from every known sin. Because as far as you continue to live in sin, the ancestral powers continue to pursue you. And then the next thing is to wage war against this ancestral power. And that basically is why we are here today. Then before we leave this place, I will teach you one small homework you have to do. 12 midnight.
Yago meji la loru.
And make sure you carry out your own assignment.
Ese ri daju pe e se ti.
There are many people.
Opolopo eniyan lo wa.
It'll be a tragedy if you leave this particular meeting and these yokes are still pursuing you. Are you here? You keep dreaming of going back to where you were born. The magnet of ancestral powers. Are you here? And you find yourself always roaming around in the forest. Ancestral powers. Are you here? You're always being pursued by all kinds of spirits. Ancestral powers. Are you here? And you find that no matter how hard you pray, it's the first resisting you. Ancestral powers. Are you here? And you find that the iniquity of your father's house, something is pushing you to want to go and do the same thing now. Maybe your great grandfather, your grandfather, your father, they were all polygamists. And now something is pushing you to be roaming around girlfriends.
Today
you claim to be born again. Those ancestral powers are already in motion. Are you here?
Have you
noticed that in your family line is all poverty? And now you have some money, but the enemy is now sipping away that money little by little. Wanting to return you to the poverty line.
The
ancestral powers. Rise up on your feet, beloved. Rise up on your feet now. Rise up on your feet. All eyes closed. Rise up on your feet, all eyes closed. Now get yourself ready. These prayers may sound very strange. It may even sound completely irrelevant to your situation. I counsel you to pray. You may even feel you don't need it. Or you are above those kind of prayers. I counsel you to still pray. Sometimes what it takes to destroy a big thing is a small thing. Ignorance is a disaster. Ignorance is a tragedy. If our sensual powers can finish Moses up,
it
can finish anyone up. Sisters, are you here this morning? Sisters, I can't hear you. Sister, say this after me loud and clear. Say, covenant and power.
Majemu adiagbara
of cola nut and alligator pepper.
Tiobi atare.
Can I hear the sister saying this? Linking me to ancestral powers. Can the sisters now shout everything loud and clear?
Majemu adiagbara obi adiatare to so mi po mo awon agbara irandiran.
Brothers, shout it louder than the sisters. Everybody shouting it loud and clear. There is already a protest going on. Can you shout it again loud and clear? In the name of
of Jesus. Deal with the covenant and power. In the name of Jesus. Oh, yes. Yes, continue, continue. You see, this is why you are here.
We did not know we were
here. I told you before,
but we will bring it down
that we are here to battle this
mouse.
Yes. In Jesus' name we pray.
Loruko Jesu agbadura.
Oh yes.
Then.
Silence, beloved.
You dagero lo wara.
As someone there with a breathing problem.
Enikan wa nibi to ni isoro pelu mimi.
Find it so difficult to breathe clearly.
O nira fun lati mi gere.
The power of God is coming upon you now.
Agbara Olorun n ba le o bayi.
And that yoke has been broken completely.
Ajaga wo si ti fo patapata.
Someone with a hole in the heart.
Enikan ti o n be lokan re.
A young person with a hole in the heart.
Odo ni onito n supe o wa ni okan re.
That hole in the heart has been melted away.
Iwo wo ti pora bayi.
The enemy has been attacking the skin of somebody.
Ota ti n gbogun ti awo ara enikan.
Right there where you are. The transforming power of the Holy Ghost is coming upon your skin, and the witchcraft marks upon the skin is wiped away by the blood of Jesus. You see, many things are happening. Someone is here at you.
And it come baby.
It's like all your internal organs have been stolen. One by one, they are returning them back to position.
Then,
as a result of that prayer, we just pray now. There is a surgical operation. Going on in so many lives. Things are being removed. Healing is taking place. Yes.
Ben.
Shout this again loud and clear. Covenant and power. Of any libation. Linking me to ancestral powers.
Yes.
This prayer.
I do like.
Will release some people into their greater wealth. Covenant and power of any libation linking me to ancestral powers. In the name of Jesus, destroy the power of libation. Spirit of the living God,
re,
Oh yes.
Ben.
Yes, that's it.
Ben, you
have been set free.
Undominera.
Today is today.
Odilo ni je.
Amen.
Amen.
Silence.
Lo idakeroro.
The swellings in the body.
I want to tola guara.
Sponsored by witchcraft.
To wala to wa waje.
They are being removed.
On kuro bayi.
And if you are that person.
But if you are alone, tongue.
The cobwebs and personal rain is troubling your life. And personal sand, I see somebody is pouring sand on you. Right
there
where you are, the power of God is coming
on
you. And the yoke of that power is broken completely. Yes. Shout this louder than anyone here. Covenant and power.
Maje mu ati agbara
of any mark or incision.
Ti amigami tabi bere
linking me with ancestral power.
To so mi po mo awon agbara irodiro.
Covenant and power.
Maje mu ati agbara
of any mark or incision.
Ti ami kami tabi bere
linking me with ancestral power.
To so mi po mo awon agbara.
In the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
That's right. Yes. Aha. Yes. 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 Yes.
Good.
Yes,
Ben.
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 Yes, Ben. Yes, Ben. Yes, yes,
Ben.
Jesus' name we pray.
Loruko Jesu agbadura.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oshio Jesu.
If you are from the eastern part of this country, don't allow anybody's voice overshadow your voice as you pray this prayer. Everybody should shout this to loud and clear. Any evil tree assigned against my destiny, I separate my life from you. We want to separate our life from the tree first. Before we command the tree to die. Any evil tree assigned against my life, I separate my life from you. In the name of Jesus, let there be a separation. Let there be a separation. A separation.
Suppress your life from it. Look at what is happening over there. That's why
believe.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Loruko Jesu lagbadura.
Yes.
Then.
Now you rest part B of that prayer.
Awa gba pa keji adura yen.
Any evil tree.
Gbogbo igi buburu
keji my destiny.
To ha yo mo mi mo.
In the name of Jesus. Thank you,
Jesus.
I wish you could see what is happening now. Raise up your right hand to the heavenlies. Don't joke with this prayer too. Thou power of evil handshake. You never can tell who shook your hands when you were a baby.
Oh, listen to Paul, long, but to your mom,
and what they shook your hands with.
I don't tell people, lower.
That power of evil handshake.
You walk by a pony, lower, buburu.
In the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
Deal with that power. In the name of Jesus. Deal with that power in the name of Jesus. Deal with that power. In the name of Jesus. Marabo kapande sanda. Ribosa ponda kaya boshendi. In Jesus' name we pray.
Loruko Jesu lagbadura.
Now begin to shake that hand.
Abe, see me a wano.
Shake it.
Me a wano.
That's right.
Then
something has happened to that hand.
Oh, come share, let's your wano.
Shake it.
Me a wano.
The serpent in the hand.
Ijo to bend your wano.
We shake you out.
Agbonjadi.
Cobwebs in the hand.
Jankari wo to bend your wano.
Shake you out.
Agbonson.
The satanic wedding rings.
Oruka satani to bend your
wano. On the hands, we shake you out.
Agbonson.
The gloves of darkness. Upon the hands, we shake you off. In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Lay that same hand on your head now.
Power.
You
are God
of evil laying on of hands.
I
don't know who has laid hands on your head, and I don't know when they did. But something must happen to you today.
That
power of evil laying of hands. In the name of
Jesus.
Spirit of the living God. In Jesus' name we pray.
Loruko Jesu lagbadura.
You may remove your hand from your head now. Somebody's here. They're cooking your body in a witchcraft cauldron. And that's why it's appearing that somebody is setting fire under your skin. Right
there
where you are, the power of God is coming upon you. And the yoke of that evil fire is broken. Now it's a sister down there. Is this enemy that comes to you at night trying to pull out your heart? Right there where you are, the power of God is coming upon you. And that yoke is broken completely. Noises in the head. The powers making those noises have been evacuated from your life now. Shout this with holy anger. Every naming ceremony ritual linking me with ancestral powers. Can I hear the sisters shouting this loud and clear? Brothers shouting loud and clear. Everybody shouting this loud. Death! In the name of Jesus. Name we pray. We are now getting to some technical areas. Technical areas. Any cowry.
Bobo weyo.
Revealing my secret.
Don't fear, she didn't mean her.
Can you shout this loud and clear? Hear the word of the Lord!
Baroluwa!
In the name of Jesus! That's right! Something is happening. Something is happening. Yes. Yes, yes. In Jesus' name we pray.
Loruko Jesu la gbadura.
The next prayer.
Adura to kan.
3 times.
Emeta.
3 times.
Emeta la gba.
As we are praying this prayer.
Baba tin gbadura na.
For in this meeting today.
Ba wa ni ipade toni.
And the enemy has been tormenting you.
Tota si tin da oloro.
With miscarriage.
Pelu oyun to nwale.
Still birth. Or children die immediately after birth. Find a way to this altar.
And
be on your knees.
As
we pray this particular prayer now. Everybody will shout this with boiling anger. Every anxiety.
Every
ancestral mother.
Bobodo inodino
pounding my blessings.
Tonku ibuku mi.
We are going to pray this on three hot times. Can I hear you shouting this loud and clear? I'm sure you can shout it louder than that. Make it with, shout it with holy anger. Make it a lot louder than that. Yeah! In the name of Jesus. Yes. Spirit of the living God.
If your Lord allow you,
begin to move. Move, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.
Loruko Jesu, agbadura.
Get us up ready. Get us up ready. This is number two.
Ekeji le.
Open your mouth and pray.
Agbadura le kanzi.
Something is happening. Continue to say it. The power of God.
Move.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Loruko Jesu, agbadura.
This is the last time.
Oh,
look at what the Lord is doing here. Open your mouth and pray. Deal with the matters of darkness. Yes. Oh, yes. In Jesus' name we pray.
Loruko Jesu, agbadura.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oshun Jesu.
Amen.
Amen.
Those of you at the front, lay your hands on your stomach. Lord, let your power locate this, your children here, one by one. Let the spirit of death in the womb begin to go out now. In the name of Jesus. Let the serpent that eats away children depart now in the name of Jesus. Every ancestral curse issued against your life, I cancel it now in the name of Jesus. The affliction of miscarriage stillbirth. And that children, let that affliction be broken to pieces in the name of Jesus.
And the affliction shall not rise again. It shall not rise again. In the name of Jesus. Go back to your seat rejoicing now. Go back to your seat rejoicing now. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody has been healed from a satanic deafness. Somebody has been healed too from witchcraft inspired blindness. Thank you, Jesus. There are many people here today who within the next 48 hours we begin to witness the kind of progress they've never witnessed before. Because many things have happened here today. And more things will still happen. Thank you, Jesus. Say this now with boiling anger. Every evil trade by butter. Linking me with ancestral powers. Can you shout this loud and clear? Your time is up. In the name of Jesus. Deal with this satanic trade by butter. Amen.
Amen.
Begin to thank the Lord for what He has done for you already.
To praise
His holy name. What a mighty God we serve. Glorious in holiness. Fearful in praise. Do wonders. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Raise your two hands to the heavenly Spirit. Lord,
Oluwa,
we have come here this morning. We have come the way we like. But we don't want to go home the same. All hands that are pointed towards you now, dear ones, let there be no hand that will come down without blessing. In the name of
Jesus.
Every hindrance of the past. Every attack of the past. That has kept anyone stagnant. Let the yoke be broken down. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Wave those hands to the Lord. Wave the hands to the Lord. And begin to say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Shout it loud, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now pronounce this loud and clear. Let the milk and honey of this land locate
my life. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray that prayer. In Jesus' name we pray.
Loruko Jesu lagbadura.
Shout a loud amen.
Eshe ami torile.
Shout a louder amen.
Eshe ami torile.
Shout even a glorious amen.
Eshe ami tologo.
Now say what I'm going to say now after me.
Ewu tele mi bayi.
Or you can write it.
Esi le ko sile.
Say I cut off.
Okay.
Every spiritual umbilical cord. Linking me with ancestral powers.
To so mi po mo awon agbara iranduran.
Can you say that and let me hear you?
Okay. Gbogbo okun ibi temi to so mi po mo awon agbara iranduran.
I cut off.
Okay.
Every spiritual umbilical cord. Linking me with ancestral powers. That's the first prayer. Second one. Every placenta manipulation. Linking me to ancestral powers.
To so mi po mo awon agbara iranduran.
I cancel you now.
Mo fagile yin bayi.
So the first price I cut off. Every spiritual umbilical cord. Linking me with ancestral powers. Second one is every placenta manipulation. Linking me to ancestral powers. I cancel you now. Tonight. By 12 midnight. Rise up. If you want to sleep before them, put on your alarm clock to wake you up. But the best is to remain awake. You will anoint your fingers with oil. And put your hand on your navel point, on your belly button. And pray these prayers for 10 minutes.
Then
you can go and sleep. Do you understand? Two prayers.
Adura meji.
Anoint your finger with oil. Put it on your belly button, your navel point area, and pray this prayer for 10 minutes. These two prayers. And then go and sleep.
Go to losun.
Let's rise up on our feet now. Our Lord and our God, we thank you for this day. I will praise the holy name for bringing your people here. It is written that they to the hills will raise up their heads. From there comes their help. Their help comes from the Lord who made heavens and
earth.
You will not suffer their feet to be moved.
For
he that keepeth them will not slumber. That keepeth Israel shall never slumber nor sleep. The Lord shall keep you going and you're coming out. The Lord shall keep you in all your ways. No evil shall befall you. Neither shall any plague move near your
camp.
As you go, it shall be well with you. I soak any vehicle, any aircraft, anywhere you will travel for the rest of this year in the blood of Jesus. It shall be well with you. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. The Lord will bless you from Zion. And make his face to shine upon you. And be gracious unto you. And as this year is running to an end, and the enemy is trying to balance his account, you will not be a candidate in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Thanks for watching. remember to click the subscribe button and the notification bell beside it to be updated with Ebenezer Meek channel's video whenever available. Don't forget to comment, like, and share the video with your friends and family. Bye.